One of the most frequently asked questions we get from our customers is on the process of breaking in an engine. Proper engine break-in ensures that early engine wear is kept to a minimum and that the oil flows smoothly and evenly throughout all moving parts. Our biggest concern following an engine overhaul is the break-in procedure. Not performing the procedure correctly can run the risk of oil consumption, low power, and high fuel consumption. That's not a product problem, it's a workmanship problem. Our goal is to make sure that when you overhaul your engine, the break-in procedure is done the right way. Why do you break in a diesel engine? It is important to break in a diesel engine because it controls your oil consumption, controls your fuel economy, and it affects your power. These three items are some of the things that customers expect when they overhaul an engine or repair an engine, and that they are improved. If you do not break in the engine properly, all three of these things can be worse than when you sent your engine to the repair shop. So, how do you break in an engine? We at Highway & Heavy Parts always want you to refer back to the manufacturer's service manual loaded with all their procedures. In summary, there's two different ways that you can accomplish that. The break-in procedure means putting the load on the engine. So, we can back it on the dyno and load the engine very easily. Unfortunately, most of us don't have dynos to break in engines. Driving your truck at a location with a lot of hills is an option. You may be asking yourself, what's next? Do you put a loaded trailer behind it? Once loaded, do you get the boost pressure up? However you accomplish the load, you can verify that you are loading the engine by your boost pressure gauge. Engine break-in, whose responsibility is it? It's both the customer and the repair shop. The reason why? It's very hard to break in an engine at a repair shop. It's also the customer's best interest to have the engine broken in properly. So there's a couple ways of working together with the repair shop that you can achieve this. A lot of our customers will bring a loaded trailer to the repair shop and have it ready for pickup as soon as the engine is done. Communicate with the repair shop and ask to be present when the engine is started. That way, you're able to go out and drive the engine, putting on 3 to 4 hours of road time on the engine with a loaded trailer. This will help avoid raising the shop rate or having to bill more hours. Now, you're working together with the shop in great communication. If a shop technician is performing an engine break-in without the customer present, follow the usual standard procedure. Start the engine, let it run, check your fluids, and contact the customer. Let them drive it or confirm that they'll correctly break in the engine. It's both the customer and the repair shop's responsibility to make sure the break-in procedure is done correctly. For more information, contact one of our ASC certified parts technicians at 844-447-1453 or visit us online at highwayandheavyparts.com. Be sure to like this video and hit the subscribe button on Facebook and YouTube to stay up to date on all news from Highway & Heavy Parts. From diagnosis through delivery, we're Highway & Heavy Parts.